Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
When they had come near Jerusalem and had reached Bethpage at the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two disciples, saying to them, "Go into the village ahead of you, and immediately you will find a donkey tied and a colt with her. Untie them and bring them to me. If anyone says anything to you, just say this, 'The Lord needs them,' and he will send them immediately." This took place to fulfill what had been spoken through the prophet, saying, "Tell the daughter of Zion, look, your king is coming to you, humble and mounted on a donkey, and on a colt, the foal of a donkey." The disciples went and did as Jesus had directed them. They brought the donkey and the colt and put their cloaks on them, and he sat on them. A very large crowd spread their cloaks on the road, and others cut branches from trees and spread them on the road. The crowd that went ahead of them and that followed were shouting, "Hosanna to the Son of David! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord! Hosanna in the highest heavens!" When he entered Jerusalem, the whole city was in turmoil, asking, "Who is this?" The crowds were saying, "This is the prophet Jesus from Nazareth in Galilee." The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. We praise you, O God, for redeeming the world through our Savior Jesus Christ. Today he entered the holy city in triumph and was proclaimed Messiah and King by those who spread garments and branches along his way. Bless these branches and all who carry them. Grant us grace to follow our Lord in the way of the cross, so that joined to his death and resurrection, we enter into life with you. Through the same Jesus Christ who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Amen.
Oh.
Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
As we now enter into the contemplation of the passion of our Lord Jesus Christ and meditate on the salvation of the world through his suffering, death, burial, and resurrection, let us pray. Everlasting God, in your endless love for the human race, you sent our Lord Jesus Christ to take on our nature, to suffer death on the cross. In your mercy, enable us to share in his obedience to your will and in the glorious victory of his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
A reading from Isaiah. The Lord God has given me the tongue of a teacher, that I may know how to sustain the weary with a word. Morning by morning, the Lord God wakens my ear, to listen as those who are taught. The Lord God has opened my ear, and I was not rebellious. I did not turn backward. I gave my back to those who struck me, and my cheeks to those who pulled out the beard. I did not hide my face from insult and spitting. The Lord God helps me, therefore I have not been disgraced. Therefore I have set my face like flint, and I know that I shall not be put to shame. The one who vindicates me is near. Who will contend with me? Let us stand together. Who are my adversaries? Let them confront me. It is the Lord God who helps me. Who will declare me guilty? Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God.
Have mercy on me, O Lord, for I am in trouble. My eye is consumed with sorrow, and also my throat and my belly.
For my life is wasted with grief, and my years with sighing. My strength fails me because of affliction, and my bones are consumed.
I am the scorn of my enemies, a disgrace to my neighbors, a dismay to my acquaintances. When they see me in the street, they avoid me.
Like the dead, I am forgotten, out of mind. I am as useless as a broken pot.
For I have heard the whispering of the crowd. Fear is all around. They put their heads together against me. They plot to take my life.
But as for me, I have trusted in you, O Lord. I have said, you are my God.
My times are in your hand. Rescue me from the hand of my enemies and from those who persecute me.
Let your face shine upon your servant. Save me in your steadfast love.
A reading from Philippians. Let the same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, who, although being in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited, but relinquished it all, taking the form of a slave, being born in human likeness. And being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God also highly exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bend in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God.
Welcome back to What's Happening News. From Jerusalem to Jericho, we've got the news that's got you talking. Today's top story is of a celebrity rabbi who recently entered the city in a pretty unusual way. Once a small-town carpenter's son, Jesus of Nazareth has been making a name for himself around the countryside for the last several years since John the Baptist baptized him. Some think he might rise to political power, Others are simply mesmerized by his continuous stream of miracles, and some are just jumping to see what he will do next. What is everyone talking, though, right now, is his unusual parade that accompanied him into the city of Jerusalem this week. Riding on a donkey, a colt that had never been ridden before, that his disciples acquired for him, people all over started laying down their cloaks and branches on the road for him. People then started shouting out, "Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest." It was a sight to behold. As always, though, we want to hear what you have to think. So we took to the streets and to hear all about what you had to say about Jesus and his unusual entry into the city. Let's listen to some interviews. What are your feelings about Jesus of Nazareth?
I am a longtime follower and fan of Jesus. Jesus performs the most amazing miracles that leave crowds of people stunned with awe. Personally, I'm always guessing at what he will do next. Will he cast out another demon or heal someone who's sick or bring back to life someone who died or calm a storm or walk on water? I mean, these are all things that he has done. Honestly, though, he has done so many miracles that I don't even think the scribes could keep track of them all.
Do you have a favorite miracle that Jesus has performed?
It's really tough to pick just one since there have been so many. I mean, it seems like everywhere he goes, people who need healing follow him, and he heals so many of them. It's like people just surround him everywhere he goes, hoping that by being in his presence, he could do for them what would be impossible for anyone else to do. I guess if I had to choose, though, I would pick the time when Jesus fed 5,000 people. Jesus and his disciples had gotten into a boat to get away from the crowd of people, but when they realized where the boat was headed, the crowd hurried to that place on foot and got there before Jesus and the disciples did. I'm sure they probably weren't too happy that their rest was interrupted, but Jesus, being Jesus, just looked at the crowd with compassion and began to teach. And when it got late, the disciples wanted to send everyone away to find food for themselves, but Jesus vetoed that idea. Instead, he had the disciples have everyone sit in groups on the grass. And when everyone was seated, it was easy for those who were close to see that Jesus took just a tiny bit of food that had been found, 5 loaves and 2 fish. And Jesus took it, and he looked up to heaven, he blessed the food, and he broke the loaves, and he gave it to the disciples to distribute among everyone. And then he divided up the fish too. Wouldn't you know, everyone had enough to eat. And when everyone was done and the leftovers were collected, there were 12 whole baskets. It's such an amazing story. I wish I could have been there myself.
And what do you think of Jesus' unusual entry into Jerusalem?
I got to be in the crowd to see him come in. I was there shouting, "Hosanna!" at the top of my lungs. It was so exciting to finally see him in person myself. I hope that while he's here, I'll get to listen to him speak or maybe even see him perform a miracle while he's in the city. That would be even better than the stories others tell me about what they've seen Jesus has done.
Are you familiar with the Jesus of Nazareth?
I have heard of Jesus, but I haven't made up my mind yet.
Can you elaborate on that?
Well, Jesus must be someone special to perform all of the miracles that have really made him famous. But sometimes he does things that are confusing, like openly talking to and eating with tax collectors and sinners. He doesn't seem to shy away from people who are rejected by society. He doesn't seem to be bothered by a person's reputation or concerned that it might tarnish his own. He doesn't even seem to pause and debate whether what he's doing on a daily basis, healing the sick, raising the dead, casting out demoniacs, or eating with the questionable company he keeps, might make him unclean He just does it. Then there are other matters that also make me pause and want to investigate who he is more. Like, why is it that people clamor to him from all over the countryside, where he has traveled preaching, teaching, and healing people? Yet in his hometown of Nazareth, he was rejected, and rumor has it even his family was trying to rein in his behavior. His disciples follow him, but I've heard accounts where they encourage him to take action in one direction, but he does his own thing anyway. Like blessing little children, some of the most vulnerable members of our society, instead of sending them away and ignoring them like most other people would have. I guess Jesus is just an enigma that I'm going to have to puzzle out some more before I jump on the bandwagon of following him.
And what do you think of Jesus' entry into Jerusalem?
That is another puzzle to ponder. Did he ride a colt to show humility? Did the people lay down cloaks because they honor him and want to treat him as a king? I guess I'll collect more facts as his time here in the city progresses. Maybe by Passover, I'll have a better feeling about him.
What are your feelings about Jesus of Nazareth?
As a priest, it is my calling to uphold the laws and decrees set forth for us by our holy scriptures. It is also important that we consistently discuss the texts and hold our teachers accountable so that they do not veer too far off what is accepted and understood. We have laws and commandments for a reason, so that we function well as a society. The laws tell us our place, what we should and should not do. They help us serve God in the way that God calls us to serve. That being said, I'm not so sure Jesus, as popular as a teacher as that he seems to be, takes the laws and the commandments seriously. On several occasions, he and his disciples have broken the laws of not doing work on the Sabbath. He had the nerve to heal a man in the synagogue on the Sabbath and try to make those of us who are following the rules be the guilty party for not breaking them. I am sorry, but there are 6 other days of the week to work. The Sabbath was set aside for rest.
So what do you think about Jesus' unusual entry into Jerusalem?
If he simply healed people, not on the Sabbath, that would be one thing. But I was in the temple earlier, and Jesus came in angry and started driving out people who were buying and selling things in the temple, and overturned the tables of the money changers and the seats of those who sold doves, and he would not allow anyone to carry anything through the temple. He had the crowds spellbound, but those of us who are religious authorities know that this behavior in the temple and in the synagogues needs to be curtailed.
Is it correct that you are part of the inner circle of Jesus' disciples?
Yes. I was called by Jesus to leave my old life behind and follow him. Immediately, I dropped everything and have been following him ever since.
What have you witnessed or learned as a disciple of Jesus?
Jesus is always teaching us through his words and his actions. He tells the crowds parables to explain what the kingdom of heaven is like, using examples that everyone hearing would be able to picture, like farming and seed imagery. Then, when our smaller group is alone at the end of the day, he often explains what the meanings of the parables are to us. Jesus spends time in the synagogues teaching new insights into the scriptures, enlightening us to understand them in ways that we might now have interpreted them before. Together, our group has traveled a great deal while Jesus has preached and taught. I'm honored to have him as my teacher and have learned so much in these past few years.
Is it true then that as a disciple you've performed some miracles yourself?
Yes, Jesus heals and helps a lot of people, but more and more people come needing help. More and more people are seeking the promises of hope and the message of the kingdom of God come near, that Jesus has appointed some of us to be sent out into more areas, being his representative to those places, healing people, casting out demons, and teaching others. We did not go alone, though. We always went as pairs, took nothing with us, and relied on the hospitality of strangers. We weren't always successful in our endeavors, and sometimes we had to shake the dust off our feet and go on to the next place.
Can you tell us why Jesus made such an unusual entry into Jerusalem?
It was the way he requested, having two of us go and get the unridden colt and bring it to him. Personally, I tried arguing that he should ride on a war horse and show people how powerful he is, but he insisted that the colt was what he needed to ride into the city on, and so we listened to him.
Jesus' entry into the city is the first time you've ever heard of him, correct?
Yes. I happened to be by the area in the city where he came in and witnessed everything. But honestly, I have no idea who he is. He appears to be a celebrity of sorts among the crowds of people. He's really popular. What I don't know, though, is what makes him any more special than any other rabbi, priest, or prophet. No one has ever mentioned him to me. And I'm not sure I would know he existed, even now. Perhaps someone will share with me what the good news surrounding Jesus is. Then maybe I will tell some other people, who probably haven't heard of him either. Perhaps by the time the Passover is completed, Jesus of Nazareth will be a name that everyone around here knows.
Well, there you have it, folks. A variety of viewpoints and a lot of people looking forward to what will happen next for Jesus. Tune in later this week for continuous coverage of the Passover and the poll of which person we will vote on to have Pilate pardon. Until next time, this has been What's Happening News.
Thank you. With the whole church, let us confess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Relying on the promises of God, we pray boldly for the church, the world, and all in need. In Jesus, you came among us as a suffering servant. Give your church humility. Redeem your people from pride and the certainty that we always know your will. Heal us and empower us to confess Christ crucified. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. In creation, life springs from death. Redeem your creation awaiting resurrection. Restore lost habitats and endangered species. Create new possibilities for areas affected by climate change. Grant relief from natural disasters and nurture new growth. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Jesus was handed over to the powers of this world. In all nations, instruct the powerful that they would not exploit their power but maintain justice. Sustain soldiers and guide those who command them, that they serve the greatest need, and keep your peace as their aim. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. On the cross, Jesus joined all who feel forsaken. Abide with those who are condemned to death. Defend those who are falsely accused. Console and strengthen those who are mocked or bullied. Accompany all who suffer, especially Margaret, Carl, Jan, Carol, Anne, Tim, Roger, Paula, Audrey, Joanne, Deborah, and Casey Marie. Grant them respite and renewal. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. You called followers to tend Jesus' body in death. Sustain hospice workers and funeral directors. Bless this congregation's ministries at time of death, those who plan and lead funerals, those who prepare meals, all who offer support in grief. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. You inspired the centurion to confess Jesus as your son. We praise you for the faith you have given to people of all places and times. Give us also such a faith to trust the promises of baptism and, with them, to look to the resurrection of the dead. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. We entrust ourselves and all our prayers to you, O faithful God, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Faithful God, you walk beside us in desert places, and you meet us in our hunger with bread from heaven. Accompany us in this meal that we may pass over from death to life with Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, whose life and death gave salvation to all. You gather your people around the tree of the cross, transforming death into life, and
so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the host of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
God of our weary years, God of our silent tears, you have brought us this far along the way. In times of bitterness, you did not abandon us, but guided us into the path of love and light. In every age, you sent prophets to make known your loving will for all humanity. The cry of the poor has become your own cry. Our hunger and thirst for justice is your own desire. In the fullness of time, you sent your chosen servant to preach good news to the afflicted, to break bread with the outcast and despised, and to ransom those in bondage to prejudice and sin. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, broke it, and gave thanks, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this for the remembrance of me." For as often as we eat of this bread and drink from this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes.
Christ has died.
Christ is risen.
Christ will come again.
Remembering, therefore, his death and resurrection, we await the day when Jesus shall return to free all the earth from the bonds of slavery and death. Come, Lord Jesus, and let the church say, Amen.
Amen.
Send your Holy Spirit, our advocate, to fill the hearts of all who share this bread and cup with courage and wisdom to pursue love and justice in all the world. Come, Spirit of Freedom, and let the church say, Amen.
Amen.
Join our prayers and praise with your prophets and martyrs of every age, that rejoicing in the hope of the resurrection, we might live in the freedom and hope of your Son. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against you. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Amen.
Jesus draws the whole world to himself. In this meal, all are fed.
Thank you.
body of Christ given for you. The blood of Christ shed for you. Let us pray. God of steadfast love, at this table you gather your people into one body for the sake of the world. Send us in the power of your Spirit that our lives bear witness to the love that has made us new in Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
You are what God has made you to be, created in Christ Jesus for good works, chosen as holy and beloved, freed to serve your neighbor. God bless you, that you may be a blessing. In the name of the Holy and life-giving Trinity. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Go in peace, share the good news. Thanks be to God.